Many students find it difficult to handle exam questions related to scientific investigations. They may find it hard to answer questions such as stating the hypothesis of an experiment, or identifying the independent variable, dependent variable, and control variables. Do you understand these concepts? Let's take a look at the following case and find out. Andy is a farmer. He is planning to adopt organic farming in his farmland in the upcoming year. He plans to collect coffee ground and add it to the soil. He thinks that there are some essential nutrients in the coffee ground that help improve soil fertility, thereby increasing the quality of his crops. Andy has prepared some leaf cuttings from a herbaceous plant and cultivated them in water. All cuttings are at the same growth stage and ready for the experiment. The cuttings are divided into two groups. One group is grown in soil added with coffee ground, while the other group is grown in soil without any treatment. Can you identify the hypothesis of this experiment? The hypothesis is coffee ground contains some essential nutrients for plants. Then we need to design an experiment to test the hypothesis. We need to consider the independent variable, dependent variable, and control variables when we design the experiment. Let's have a quick recap on the definition of these three variables. The factor that we're going to study in the experiment is the independent variable. It is the variable that the experimenter manipulates or changes in the experiment. A control experiment usually involves two setups, an experimental setup and a control setup. The difference between the two setups is the presence or absence of the independent variable, which is usually absent in the control setup. Dependent variable is the factor that we are going to measure. In an experiment, its value depends on changes in the independent variable. To ensure the investigation is a fair test, all the other factors that may affect the dependent variable are kept constant. These are the control variables. Let's go back to the scenario mentioned earlier. Its hypothesis is coffee ground contains some essential nutrients for plants. Also, think about the difference between the two setups. The answer is the soil in both setups, one with coffee ground added while the other doesn't. So, the independent variable is presence or absence of coffee ground in soil. But how can we prove whether or not coffee ground contains nutrients for plants? Andy's aim is to improve the quality of crops. If his hypothesis is correct, the growth of the plants will change along with the independent variable. So, the growth of plants is the dependent variable being measured. We can measure plant growth by observing the changes in the number of leaf, leaf area, or the height of the plants, depending on the type of plant we choose. And finally, it comes to the control variables. Which factors should remain unchanged during the experiment in order to ensure the investigation is a fair test? Students are required to point out 2 to 3 control variables in most exam questions. In this example, there are many factors affecting the growth of plants, but we only want to study whether the nutrients in coffee ground is essential for plant growth. In both experimental and control setups, other factors that will affect the growth of plants should remain constant, so that the experimental result will only be affected by the independent variable. The control variables of this experiment are the amount of water provided to the plants, temperature and humidity of the environment, light intensity, or the duration of light exposure. In this video, we had a brief review on the definition of the three variables and discussed how to identify them. In the next video, we will look at how to analyze an experimental setup that frequently appears in exams. If you enjoyed this video, do give us a like and share this video to your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.